In life, many people enjoy the cinema. They enjoy going to movies. And even though we're in a time of COVID and pandemic and epidemic where we're not really going places in droves where we're sitting next to people who are total strangers anymore, we are definitely taking home movies, we're definitely watching Netflix, and we're definitely looking at old film. There's an old film called The Invisible Man, of which I didn't see a whole lot of because I didn't like its premise, but I got the point that Hollywood was making. That there is a psychological capability of a person who is a bastard of the world, who likes to harm people, that can take the mind and use the subliminal subconscious to tell someone that another person is someone that they're seeing when they're really not that person at all. At the same time, there are types of psychological testing, not at all, but sort of a psychological mind morphing that can tell someone that a person is not in their house at all, that they don't see them at all. It's kind of a type of hypnosis, if you will, and sometimes hypnosis is seen as a quack doctor's business, and other times hypnosis is seen as a real scientific practice. But what we know is that the subliminal mind has the ability to hear things and do things that sometimes the conscious mind doesn't have the ability to see, feel, or do. What we have to be very careful of are the people who come into our nation from other countries that don't care one bit about our federal laws, our constitution, or our amendments. And they have no educational background at all to even conceptualize the international treaties that govern their nation of origin, let alone our nation that did that treaty in, well, gosh, the early 40s. What I'm talking about, of course, is always the Human Rights Declaration, of which 400 nations have agreed to in the United Nations, which governs all of our nations pretty much in the world. What I'm talking about is The Invisible Man as a film, but I'm also talking about the concepts of using technology to abuse people. And in that film, there was a man who was played by a famous actor that I don't need to name at this time, who was literally psychologically abusing someone in his invisibility cloak. In Harry Potter, of course, was invisibility cloak, where he snuck around and gathered data and intel, and people do that, but at the same time, when people use that invisibility of audio files to put someone to sleep, to abuse them, to molest them, to mutilate them, to rape them, to cut them, to make them bleed, we have a real problem in our communities. I'm talking about things that are very real. I'm talking about things from real personal experience, and I am talking about things that are not a part of any mental health world because those bastards in that industry don't believe anything is real. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about scientific discoveries. And when we are stupid in the world, and when we don't have proper news channels talking about the real threats to American soil and land and people's cars and houses and whatnot, we are fools in the world.